Today I'll be discussing with you our project, the Patil Wada, which is spread across a land area of around 4 acres and 1,60,000 square feet.
The site is located right on the fringe or the outskirts of the city.
Hi, this is architect Dhananjay Shinde from Nasik.
Before I start, please note that you can download the full PDF ebook of this house with detailed floor plans, photographs and fact file from buildify.com, and the link is mentioned in the description below.
The bungalow belongs to one of the leading eye surgeons of the city. All the family members of this bungalow are also doctors. So the basic brief what they put up was to have a bungalow with the feel of a farmhouse. Also, the clients, they used to have ancestral house in the village before they shifted to the city. And they always mention about lingering and lovely memories of the old ancestral courthouse with its open to sky courtyard. We thought, why not take off on that particular concept, on that particular idea. So the plan evolved around a traditional open to sky courtyard right in the center of the house, which is very prevalent in old wadas in this part of Maharashtra. So to achieve that, we introduced large and expansive verandas on the north and the entire west side, which really connects the house to the landscape all around. It's a ground plus one structure, having a simple elevation wherein it's a white is the predominant color, and mangalore tile roofing for the verandas on the ground floor, and again mangalore tile roofing for the bedrooms on the first floor. So it's a typical bungalow feel with white and terracotta finish of the mangalore tiles. The bungalow is basically, it's approached along a long linear wall punctuated by a terracotta jali, and through the jali he gets just a glimpse of the house. So now the entire house is not as such exposed as he walks along. So he has to walk along quite a few steps, you know, where he comes in to a sort of a pause area, foyer. So it is at this particular point where a person really gets a glimpse of the entire house. And from here he walks in, and on the left hand side he's got a still water body with a lily pond, and he comes to the entrance veranda. So this entrance veranda is again a very typical traditional type of a veranda with wide expanse and longish in length. As soon as a person enters the main door, he is straight away confronted by a very cozy, an intimate space of this open to sky courtyard, and suddenly there is a flood of natural light which is coming in through the courtyard and just washing the entire space or entire interiors of this house. And all the spaces, like from the courtyard, you have the living room on the right hand side which also overlooks the courtyard, the dining area which is next to the kitchen. So if somebody is sitting on the dining table, he or she, he also gets a glimpse of courtyard. Plus of course from the dining you get a glimpse towards the east side, there's a deck which connects to the landscape outside. And as in a person moves around the house, he has to move around the courtyard. So this court basically becomes a predominant feature of the house. For the material mood board, the idea was to have various palette of all natural materials. So, you know, the inside of the house, predominantly the entire flooring of the house on the ground floor and on the first floor is of steel grey granite, which is Lepanto finished throughout the house. And the broad verandas on both the sides have been finished with khaki shahabad flooring tiles, shahabad stone tiles, so stones 2 feet by 2 feet. And for the cladding of the veranda, we have used very different technique. We have put those cut pieces of shahabad which are around 1.5 inch thick, and so the size varied to around 6 inches by 9 inches. And those cut pieces, we put it in a concrete mixer and tossed it around for quite some time. What happened was it got a unique soft edges. All the toilets, we have again a very unique natural palette. So for the master toilet, what we've done is we have used Shahabad, which is antique finish. For the daughter's toilet also, we've used a stone, it's a limestone known as a rainbow, where practically literally you can see various shades of rainbow in this natural stone. For the guest toilet again, we have used the slate stone. The slate stone in a very nice silverish grey black combination. On the southwest side, we have got a pavilion which is open on all sides and just covered by a mango tile roof. For the flooring here, we have got a typical old mosaic tile. It is attached, small toilet block attached to it. In the front of the house, as a person parks and he enters, there are these huge lawn mounds which sort of screen the house, and it also gives some sort of a privacy to the lawn area inside. Then there's a steel pivoted door with triangular motifs. The central court itself is a unique design element, in the sense, even though it is a very traditional concept and much used concept all over, starting from the wood columns which we got from down south and the stone pedestal for these columns, then the sloping roof where we have got Mangalore tiles on the top, and then textured Mangalore plain tiles on the bottom. Even the risers, if you notice, have been very similar to the stone carving which used to happen in the earlier days. But here we had a very skilled mason, our tiling contractor, who could make a similar type of a pattern in steel grey granite slab. So all these elements, all these materials, the palette, wonderful natural light coming in throughout the day, the ventilation happening throughout this courtyard. So all these things, really gel together and make it a very memorable experience for the person using the house and also a person visiting the house. The construction technology is the usual RCC frame structure with brick, red brick infill walls. We have RCC slabs wherever we have a flat roof for the floors, and then all the roofs above, that is the sloping roofs for the bedrooms and the sloping roofs on the verandas, all those roofs, the sloping roofs, they are of structural steel, and then it has teak wood boarding members and finished with Mangalore tiles on the top. So overall, this house achieves the brief it started with. It really gives an effect, a feel of a farmhouse, and being a regular house totally.